Welcome to Experiment 5, learning how to use a gas chromatograph. So in this part of the experiment, you're going to be analyzing the product from your distillation by gas chromatography. And that's going to tell you directly how pure that material is based on the printout that you get from this machine. So let's get started. Like I showed in the PowerPoints, the gas cylinder is over there, so that contains helium. And then those copper tubes that you can see running along connect all these Galmac GCs with helium. So on the front here is the injection port. That's where you'll be injecting your sample. And then once you inject that and it volatilizes, that will be put into the columns, which you can see there. So the column on the left is for injection port A. That's what we'll be using. And as your sample travels through that column that's heated to 125 degrees inside this oven, as it comes off the column and hits the detector, we'll be able to record those peaks via the electrical current that it's creating on the chart recorder right there. So here's all we're going to be working with in this part of the experiment. We've got the Galmac GC, and all the parameters will be preset on there, so you really don't have to mess with any of these buttons. We've got the plotter, which we'll look at how to use in a little bit more detail. Then we've got our sample. This is my banana oil. Yours will probably be in a flask or a beaker or something. And then we've got a container of acetone and then a waste container. For you, these two will actually be labeled wash acetone and then waste. We've also got our syringe. You can see this syringe has a fine metal point, and this has a guide so you can only pull it back to a certain level. This prevents just bending of those metal parts. When you're using a syringe, you want to be really, really careful because they're not cheap and they're easy to bend. So that's something to watch out for. And then the operations manual is this paper over here to the right. So the first thing you're going to do is take your actual sample and get ready to inject that into the GC. With your syringe, you want to put that down so the needle is inside of your sample, and then pump it up and down several times like this. What that's doing is getting the air bubbles out of your syringe. So eventually, once you've got all the air bubbles out, you can pull it up and look on the markings so that you get to 1 microliter of that sample. Once you've got that 1 microliter, then you're going to come up to injection port A, and that's where you're going to inject your sample. So as you're inputting the sample, you're going to be careful because the needle is going to touch a rubber septum. It's going to kind of put some resistance. Once you push it in all the way, push, pull it out. You want to do that in a quick motion. So once that happens, immediately you want to come over here to the plotter. So once that's injected, as simultaneously as you can, you want to start this button right here on the far right, and that starts the chart recorder moving at the speed that's set on this dial. So as that's moving, it now is with this pin you can see right here, it's actually recording what you are getting off of the column. Before going too far, you want to make sure that at the very start point of where your run started, you want to use a pen to mark that injection time or as close as you can to it. So you may actually want to have a couple people working so one person can inject the sample and then you can be ready to push the button or vice versa. If your lab is an LD202, your plotter will look like this. You can see the graph paper and the pen. This little plastic edge helps you rip off the paper, and then the controls over here, the only one that you'll need to worry about is off to centimeters per minute. Everything else should be set for you. While your run is working, you might want to rinse your needle because you don't want the next person in line to have your product in there. So you're going to take up some of that wash acetone, probably 5 times, and clean out your needle so that the next person in line has a clean needle to work with. So once you've gotten the acetone and then your product and starting material peaks to come out, once that's done and all the peaks have passed this plastic guard right here, then you want to stop the chart over on the far right side, hold down the plastic guard, and then tear up so that you get your GC trace and you can start analyzing to get the peak areas off that trace. Also, don't forget to record the parameters used by the GC in experiment 5. All these parameters should go in your procedure, and notice that a lot of the parameters correspond to what's up on a lot of these buttons. So you don't need to touch those have already been preset, and you should just have to kind of write it down in case you needed to reproduce your experiment. So again, using the GCs is pretty simple, just a few tasks. Make sure that you read through the instruction manual as you're using the GC. And if you have any questions, ask your TA. They'll probably be monitoring to make sure you're using the syringes and injecting those properly and using the plotter properly as well. So good luck in experiment 5.